This is an emergency broadcast. I repeat, an emergency broadcast. If you have already or are about to upgrade to a Zen 2 CPU, commonly referred to as Ryzen 3000, please make sure you watch the entirety of this video. Hello, my fellow tech enthusiasts. I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. All right, so in the few months that preceded the release of Zen 2, a lot of back and forth was going on to know which motherboard would be supported. First, I'll quickly break down how to identify such motherboards, and then I'll explain why you should be careful before you install anything new, BIOS or CPU. So let's break it down. According to a post made by an AMD representative on Reddit, any motherboards that supported a CPU with a 105-watt TDP should be compatible with the Ryzen 3000 lineup, but no, it's not a guarantee. Some early low-budget motherboards did have a max TDP of 65-watt and would only be compatible with the Ryzen 3000 65-watt CPUs like the 3700X. Other motherboard vendors might just outright not support the CPUs. Of course, the best way to make sure your motherboard is compatible is to go to the product page of your specific motherboard. Let's take a look at mine, for example. I googled the name of my motherboard. I mean, of course it's going to be supported. It's a B350 ASUS ROG Strix. So yeah, it's going to be supported, right? Anyways, I clicked on something that resembles a support page and looks for CPU / memory compatibility. I scrolled down to the list, or you can do a page search and wait, what? Yep, my motherboard doesn't look like it features compatibility with the 12-core 3900X. Now, before you try and put a dunce hat on my head saying that obviously B350 wouldn't be supported, let's take a look at this ASRock AB350 board or this A320 board which supports it. So yeah, despite what anyone says, make sure you check. The second thing now is the BIOS update. AMD had to do a lot of messing around with the BIOS because a lot of motherboards were equipped with too small of a BIOS chip. In the new BIOS for your motherboard, you might find that some older A-series, Athlons, or Bristol Ridge CPUs will not be supported. But that's not the big thing here. The big thing is that if you have a RAID config, do not update your BIOS. I repeat, do not update your BIOS. Unless you, of course, have a proper external backup of your system. Some companies had to kick out the RAID module out, which basically breaks your SATA RAID on so many motherboards. The reason why I explicitly mention having an external backup is because if you are using RAID 1 or RAID 5 for that, you might have a bad time. Currently, Techpower Up identified this issue with MSI motherboards only, but many other motherboard vendors feature the same small 16 megabyte BIOS chip. So if you are going to buy Ryzen 3000, make sure you have a proper backup. If you don't, don't update your BIOS, it's just not worth it right now. Because they also had to cut out other stuff, other features to be able to fit the new BIOS in. I know that I'm repeating myself, but I don't want any of you guys to lose all of your information. It happened to me once and I would not wish it on anybody else. In my case, I plugged in my external backup into my Xbox and it basically just formatted the whole thing. But yeah, you know, different situations but same result. Alright, so what else is there to talk about with AMD? Oh yeah, if you were able to buy a Ryzen 3000 chip, I say if, because a lot of you guys saw it instantly as backorder, but if you managed to snag one, double check to see if you are eligible for the Xbox Game Pass promo. Apparently, Newegg did not include codes in the purchases up until 2:30 PM on launch day, which means that if you got it right away when the stores opened or basically online when it became available, you might not receive your code. A similar situation happened with Micro Center, so make sure you check. The companies who don't honor the deal will probably have to retroactively fix that though, since AMD's terms and conditions state that the promo started on the 1st of July, a whole week before the release of the CPUs. Let's wrap up this episode with one last AMD story. In case you didn't know, third-party designs for the now much more affordable RX 5700 series will not be available until at least mid-August, so about a month after the launch. This was confirmed by the lead of the Radeon brand himself, Scott Herkelman. Not only that, but apparently they might have plans to create a second reference design for the GPUs with dual or triple fans. I mean, they already had that with the Radeon 7. I don't know why or who thought it was a good idea to go back to blower styles. Anyways, guys, this video was also a little bit different to make to me. Let me know if you want me to keep the slightly updated intro or if you preferred the older one. As usual, you can click right here to see the latest video right here to subscribe to the channel. Stay frosty, my dudes, and I'll see you on the next one. I truly have to stay frosty because I'm sweating here. Hold on, let me turn on my AC. Almost forgot.